Hello, this is Bern, and if you're a single woman and you're asking yourself, where on earth are all the amazing quality men hiding? Well, on today's episode, I'm going to be sharing with you five top reasons why you might be missing out on connecting with awesome guys. So stick around. Hello, this is Bern. Welcome to your great lifetv.com. Today's another edition of Get the Love You Crave. And on today's episode, I'm going to be sharing with you five top reasons why you might be missing out on connecting with awesome quality men. First, a disclaimer. Listen, I've been around the block. I am 42 years of age. I coach women from all over the world to find awesome guys. So please know that I understand that not every single guy that you connect with will be awesome. There's plenty of guys who are narcissistic. There's plenty of guys who are douchebaggy. There's plenty of guys who just want it for themselves. They're not interested in what's best for you. So please don't send me messages regarding that, because I'm aware of what's out there in the world. Here's my beef. There's plenty of men who are awesome quality. There's plenty of men who are family focused. There's plenty of men who are into service of women. There's plenty of guys who are into connecting and sharing with generosity. Now, if you're not connecting with them and you're putting all men into the category of the first group that I explained, you're doing yourself a disservice. There's plenty of awesome men out there. If you are not seeing them, here are five reasons why this could be happening. They're not the only reasons, but maybe in one of or two you can identify yourself. The first one is because you have developed a place in your heart subconsciously that you call home. The way sometimes that you understand, you learn, you first come in contact with love is what you call home. Love feels like, and sometimes love feels like hurt, or love feels like abuse, or love feels like both. And if that's what you learned at home is, and you haven't changed your programming, then you've gone out trying to get the same level of subconscious pain that you experienced in childhood instead of connecting with something that's better than that. So it's not just that there's bad guys out there. Sometimes you have craved them subconsciously and have connected with dudes who can't give you what you want. And then comes the worst part. You've believed that that's all that's out there. So that's the first reason. Second reason is many women who can't seem to connect with awesome men are very hooked into the initial high. The initial high of how exciting it feels, how awesome, how breathtaking, how ocean parting, how eyes locking into each other, how karmic the connection, all that stuff. I'm not saying it's not important, but a few women have felt that that is the mark of a good man, where you feel strong, passionate chemistry of the kind where your oceans part, no pun intended. That's a good guy. And many of those guys are players. Many of those guys are guys who have found a way into your panties, and they say the right thing and they act the right way, but they don't have your best interest at heart. Am I saying all guys who show up that way are that way? No. But many guys who create that initial passionate spark at the highest level may not be the best guy for you, and you might be somewhat addicted to that feeling and not being able to see past those initial emotions and miss out on some incredible guys where you could have strong chemistry with, but maybe not the first date, maybe the 10th date or the 5th date or something, and the first time you didn't feel it and you let them go. So that's another reason why a lot of women don't connect with awesome men. They are hooked into guys who create that initial junky feeling of excitement and heroin, emotionally speaking, and it's unsustainable sometimes. Third, lack of high standards and lack of boundaries. What do I mean by that? Well, a lot of women don't have necessarily the highest standard in terms of what they connect with, and don't have the biggest clarity in terms of what boundaries they should enforce with men. So what happens when you don't have that lack of clarity or those boundaries? You connect with guys who end up hurting you. And when guys end up hurting you, you end up A, wasting a bunch of time with them because you might still develop feelings for them, and B, you end up also thinking that all guys out there are the same, which leads me to my fourth reason: beliefs. Untrue and shitty beliefs about men. Imagine that I hand over to you a pair of new Gucci sunglasses, $500, and you dip them in dog shit. And that dog shit is basically surrounding both sides, and you put them on, and then you go around your city with glasses that are $500, but smeared in dog shit. What's gonna happen? You're gonna see everything based on what's on your lenses, not based on what's in reality. So your beliefs act the same way, my dear. If you have a belief that says all men are a-holes, you're gonna look for those guys who are that way. If you say all guys are cheaters, you're gonna look for the guys that are most likely to cheat. Am I saying that no guys are cheaters or a-holes? No, but not all guys. And that's the problem. A lot of women overgeneralize and they say all guys are this way, so I might as well give up. Last one, environment. What do I mean? Well, if you're not able to find what you're looking for in your environment, but you have not gone above and beyond the call of duty to connect to other types of environments with where other types of guys hang out, with other types of even girlfriends hang out, then you're doing yourself a disservice. Why? Because what you see around your neighborhood is not what's out there in the world. What you see in this in your city is not what's out in the country. What you see in the country is not what's out in the world. So I encourage you to go well beyond your comfort zone in terms of figuring out other places where you can connect with guys who might be different from the guys that you've connected with your entire life. Now, hope this is helpful, useful, insightful. As I said, my disclaimer is that these are not the only reasons why women don't find awesome guys, but these are definitely some strong ones. So if you find this is helpful, I ask you to do three things. Number one, click like on my video. Number two, subscribe to my channel. Number three, on the description of this video or somewhere on your screen, you'll see a link that allows you to sign up right now to a free 40-minute masterclass that's gonna share with you how you can create a strong connection with a man in a lot less time with a lot less pain than your current trajectory. Thank you for allowing me to connect with you, and as always, I challenge you to live a full and a conscious life.